But they can't be negative. I can't make a negative number of cans of Coke. Okay? So that's why we have these things called non-negativity constraints that says all decision variables in linear programming problems are either zero or positive. Okay? Questions about that? Real quick. Sometimes there are. Yes, sir.
Why was there in the homework a explicit constraint saying that both x1 and x2 are greater than zero? Why?
That is a non-negativity constraint.
Does it need to be specified?
In the part one or the part two?
Well, part one.
In the part one, I'm trying to show you that this picture, and yes, then you explicitly say it's got to be greater than or equal to zero, and you'll see in a couple minutes when we do a real problem why that these two axes basically form those two constraints.
Right.
Okay? Other questions?